Hi everyone, Laura with the Vermilion County Conservation District. Today I'd like to spend a few minutes with you to discuss a renewable natural resource that we have in Vermilion County and across the world, and that's trees. A natural resource is something that we use as humans to help our daily lives be a little bit better, and a natural resource is one that we get from nature. Trees are a renewable natural resource, and the fact that they're able to be recycled and renewed in the environment pretty much on their own. And I want to show you some steps of how that happens and some cool things that we can find out about trees over the next several minutes. So let's go see what we can find in the forest. When a tree falls over dead in the forest, it doesn't just lay on the ground forever. It'll start to rot, decompose, crumble, and fall apart and get recycled back into the soil. This log that's here in front of me is a fairly recent log that has fallen into the forest. But if I show you this one here, you can see how it has started to decompose. And then there's also a fallen tree log right here that almost looks like it's part of the soil again. So what happens is anytime that it rains, the tree log will soak up that moisture. And then there's all kinds of invertebrates and vertebrate animals that will help recycle this back into the soil. So this is how a tree can start to be recycled in nature. Another added benefit for when a tree dies and falls to the floor in the forest is that it will open up the top canopy layer above our heads. So now you can see this portion of the sky is open. It allows sunlight to come through. Sunlight to reach the forest floor, so new plants and new trees can grow in that open space. One of the best decomposers of a fallen tree log are fungus. Fungus are also known as mushrooms. And on this log, you can see some beautiful red mushrooms. They're a type of a cup fungus. And right now, this fungus has roots called mycelium that go down into the tree, that dissolves the tree and takes out minerals and nutrients to survive. So mushrooms are an excellent decomposer for our trees. Another fun thing to do with the fallen tree logs that are laying on the ground is to look for some of those invertebrate animals that help decompose the tree. The best way to do that is to take the tree log and roll it over to see what we can find. So as we look at this one, you can see some earthworms that are moving around. And that's about it for this one, but we can check out a few more logs too. It's always important anytime you roll over a log in the forest that you want to put it back the way you found it, put that roof back on top of their house. That way everything stays nice and safe and protected underneath. I noticed while I was hiking that there was some sawdust material on these wild ginger leaves down here at the base of this tree. So I'm thinking, what could have made that? Where did that come from? And if I follow the tree up, you can see where the bark is starting to fall off. And even towards the top, you can see a hole or a cavity that's up there. And ooh, there's a big spider that just crawled out of that hole. I'll see if I can zoom in on it. Oh, he's beautiful. Wolf spider coming out of that hole. I know a lot of you probably are not thinking he's too cute, but spiders are excellent animals that help eat a lot of bugs that bother us. And if we leave spiders alone, they'll leave us alone too. But a woodpecker has probably made that hole. And as he was pecking that hole, a lot of the sawdust or tree material fell down to the ground. And there was a woodpecker that just called, in fact. But in this tree, you'll have all kinds of ants moving around. They've dug tunnels through the tree, and the woodpeckers will come over here and eat those ants and even that spider that has crawled out of that hole. This is a larger log that I just rolled over. Underneath the log, you can see this white, hairy, stringy stuff. That's the mycelium that I mentioned earlier with the mushrooms. That's the underground part of the fungus growing through this log before they send up the fruiting body that we love to look for. When I rolled over the log, there's a snail shell. Doesn't look like it's alive anymore. A couple more worms. underneath this log, we found a red-back salamander. He's an amphibian related to frogs and toads. Looks kind of like a snake, but he's got some tiny legs too. So salamanders love to live underneath these fallen logs as well. So here we've got ourselves another earthworm, but crawling underneath the soil is a bark beetle. That's what it looks like in the larval stage. It'll go through the metamorphic process and turn into an adult beetle at some point. They do not like that sun. That's why he's trying to get back down underneath. Oh, there was a salamander that just darted across. But that beetle is going back underneath the ground because they don't like the sunshine. And that salamander is now underneath this log. See if we can find them. Hopefully he's not crawled underneath the soil. There he is, right there. That's a two-lined salamander. They like to hide underneath all that leaf litter. While trees are growing and active and living, which some of our trees can grow to be over hundreds of years old, like our white oak trees, they will produce seeds, thousands of seeds over the course of their lifetime. And those seeds are what produce the next generation of trees. So we had a sugar maple seed fall to the ground here, and now we have a young sugar maple tree that's starting to grow. And that's how trees are a natural, renewable resource. That whole process from seed growing throughout their lives, falling over dead in the forest, and then the tree log getting recycled back into the soil by our fungus and our invertebrate animals. It's what makes that a renewable resource. So thank you for joining me again today, and we will see you again soon.